What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. I'm Katia. In today's lesson, we're going to focus on attitude adverbs. I think they can help your speech and writing be richer, more varied, and appealing. Are you ready? If so, grab your vocabulary notebook, go to the section for adverbs, and let's kick off. Before we start, as you may know, my previous lesson was on synonyms for five commonly overused adjectives. One of them was cheap. So I remembered another idiom that you can use to talk about something that is cheap. It's British and it's cheap as chips. For example, you can say it's cheap as chips, which means that it's very cheap. Now let's get down to business. We use attitude adverbs when we want to express our attitude toward the action described in the sentence. Attitude adverbs usually refer to the whole sentence. And as for their position, they are usually used at the beginning of a sentence, but they can also go before the main verb or after the verb to be, and you can also place them at the end of a sentence. Apart from using linkers in your speaking and writing exams, I'd also include at least one attitude adverb. By the same token, you shouldn't overuse them, only when you want to express your opinion and attitude towards something. There are many attitude adverbs. For today's lesson, I've chosen 15. And if you want me to make another video with more in the future, just let me know in the comments below. Now let's get started. The first attitude adverb on my list today is clearly. Clearly. It's used to show that you think that something is obvious or certain. And now let's look at two examples. The first one, it's clearly time you fixed your bike. And the second example, clearly he has to change his ways. Let's move on to our second adverb, which is obviously. Obviously. It means in a way that is easy to understand. The first example, obviously, getting enough sleep is essential in order to be full of beans. The British idiom to be full of beans means to have a lot of energy. And one more example, obviously, you need to pull your socks up if you want to pass your English exam. The British idiom to pull your socks up means to start studying or working harder. Let's move on to our third adverb, understandably. Understandably. It means the same as the previous adverb, obviously. And now let's look at two examples. The first one, Tom understandably felt disappointed when he didn't win the match. And one more example, understandably, a lot of people are reluctant to travel abroad now. Number four, apparently. Apparently. It's used when you want to say that you have heard that something is true, although you're not completely sure about it. And now, two examples. The first one, apparently, it's gonna be sunny tomorrow. And one more example, apparently, the merger fell through. Remember, to fall through means to fail to happen. We learned it a few weeks ago. Number five, personally. Or if you want, you can also add speaking. Personally speaking. And this adverb is used to give your opinion. And now let's look at two examples. The first one, personally, I set a great store on leading a healthy lifestyle. To set a great store on something means to think that something is important. It's British. An American way to express the same idea would be to put a great emphasis on something. So it would be, I put a great emphasis on leading a healthy lifestyle. And one more example, personally, I think you can achieve anything you set your mind to. To set your mind to something is a C1 idiom that means to be determined to do something and to make an effort to achieve it. Number 6, astonishingly. Astonishingly. It means in a way that is very surprising. And now, 2 examples. The first example, astonishingly, he gave all his money away and became a monk. And one more example, astonishingly, although we are connected more than ever, we meet face to face less and less. Number 7, worryingly. Worryingly. It means in a way that makes you feel worried. And now, 2 examples. The first one, worryingly, the Amazon rainforest is gradually disappearing. And one more example, worryingly, teenagers compare themselves more to their peers on account of social media, hence why their self-esteem is taking a hit. We've got 2 interesting things in this example. The first one, on account of. It means because of. I think it's a very nice way to replace because of in your essay, for example. And the second thing is to take a hit, which means to be badly affected by something. And guys, before we continue and learn more attitude adverbs, just a super quick reminder, please make sure you subscribe to English Bits and your bell icon is on. There is a weekly lesson waiting for you. It's on Sundays at 12 p.m. Thank you. And now let's continue with our lesson. Our attitude adverb number 8 is reassuringly. Reassuringly. It means in a way that makes someone feel less worried. And now let's look at 2 examples. The first one, reassuringly, there won't be any dismissals in the foreseeable future. In the foreseeable future means in the near future. I made a video on advanced synonyms to say in the future. If you haven't seen it yet, you can find the link in the description box. And one more example, reassuringly, the situation will improve soon. Number 9, interestingly. And we can also add enough. Interestingly enough. And it's used to introduce a piece of information that you think is interesting. And now let's look at 2 examples. The first one, interestingly, the movie Ibiza was filmed in Croatia. And one more example, interestingly, the moon has moonquakes. They are less common and less intense than earthquakes. Number 10, not surprisingly. Not surprisingly. It's used to say that something happened without surprising you. And now, 2 examples. The first one, you started working without having breakfast. Not surprisingly, you found it hard to concentrate. And one more example, Kate has been burning the candle at both ends for a while. Not surprisingly, she had a nervous breakdown. The idiom to burn the candle at both ends means to work from very early in the morning until very late at night and so get very little rest. Let's continue number 11, curiously. Curiously. It means in a way that is unusual and strange. And now let's look at 2 examples. The first one, curiously, Rebecca refused to answer the inspector's questions about her friend's death. This example is based on the series I have just watched. It's called The One and it's available on Netflix. It's science fiction. It's based on the novel of the same name, and it's about how in the future people might be matched with their true love through DNA testing. So if you want to know what Tinder will be like in the future, don't miss it. It's intriguing, gripping, captivating. It's so good. Don't miss it. Be one. And one more example. Curiously, her eyesight is perfect at the age of 90, and she also sleeps like a log. To sleep like a log means to sleep very well. Let's continue. Number 12, strangely enough. Strangely enough. It's used to say that something is true, even though it's surprising or unusual. And now, two examples. The first one, strangely enough, Harrison Ford has never won an Oscar. And the second example, strangely enough, cotton candy was invented by a dentist. Cotton candy is American, and the British word is candy floss. Number 13, funnily enough. Funnily enough. It's a synonym of strangely enough. And now, two examples. The first one, funnily enough, I was thinking about you when you called me. And the second example, imagine it's a conversation between two people. One person says, I'd like to buy a vintage car. And another person answers, funnily enough, I have one that I'd like to sell. Two more to go. Number 14, fortunately. Fortunately. It means happening because of good luck. For example, fortunately, in the end, it didn't rain and we had a lovely walk in the mountains. And the second example, fortunately, the tow truck arrived quickly. And last but not least, the opposite of fortunately is unfortunately. And it's used to express regret or to say that something is sad or disappointing. The first example, unfortunately, my trip to Dublin was cancelled. And the last example, unfortunately, the second season of Away wasn't picked up by Netflix. So guys, that's it for today. Thank you very much for having watched this video up to the very end. I really hope you found it useful, and these attitude adverbs will help your speech and writing be richer and more interesting and varied. If you found this video useful, I would be very, very grateful if you could give it a huge thumbs up, as it's very motivating and encouraging. And don't forget to subscribe to English Bits and catch me on Instagram and do my daily quiz. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao for now!